Hello and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2 Geheimnisnacht. So I kind of forgot what we were doing since last time. I know we were building or crafting a sword for us, and I know we are training a Wyvern. And we are currently raiding the Ungols apparently. We soon have enough money to actually make a ring or an amulet, which is nice. But our expansion plans... Oh, you know what? I probably should take out this goblin before he gets destroyed by this guy. You have only have 900 men. The other one has 2,000. So either I crush him, this sentient robsman, or we crush this guy. Hmm. I could probably easier take out his this guy right now. Like, what are you attacking? The invasion of Taldum. Yes, let's attack the Taldum as well, because now we are at war with this guy. And I will just call in all of my... You know what? No. Yeah, just call in my vassals. They will handle this for me, hopefully. And maybe I don't actually have to use my own troops. I would like to build up Kislev a bit more, to be honest. Do I want to use my money for that? Kind of, yes. I would love to know where exactly this trade route is, but I think I'm gonna use my money to build up the Greenskin Palisade here to the last level, just so that Kislev is a little bit safer. We are still raiding the Ungols. Oh, there's a rebellion now. Right there. Some of my vessels have been fighting them already. No, you know what? This guy, he's an idiot. You can keep him. Well, he's been captured by rats, so clearly he is an idiot. Nomad agitation. I thought I built a... Okay, it's soon to be done. The troll pen has been built in my capital. That is always a good... thing to know about, because now, wow, we have so many trolls. Like, I hope they are actually as good as I think they are, but I expect them to be. Okay, so my vassals, where are you going? Could you please... Okay, let's raise some of our forces to actually take out this rebellion. This should be more than enough. And you know, we can just raise the rest of them and send them over to Taldum and, you know, conquer the Greenskin land over here. Yeah, the rebellion has no chance against us. Not even remotely. I also will probably test the dual engine a little bit more, like what is dodging doing and, you know, blocking. Right now I'm just attacking and hoping to win, but maybe we'll just test it out what the other features can do, like the other options. Okay, yes. We got money. Do I already have one? I have cavalry leader, because that's so important for green skins, because we have so much cavalry. Aggressive leader. Fight another day. You know, damage is not bad, and pursuit is also nice. Let's go for aggressive leader. That seems like very green skin like. He should not win this war now, because, you know, you are definitely winning the war. You are also winning the war. Let's just crush you real quick. Like your army, and then you shouldn't be able to win the war. Without your army. And because we will conquer the rest of these lands. Greenskin Palisade has been built in Kislev already. Oh, and we might actually have to few to take him on. I just noticed. Yeah. That's no good. I forgot that greenskins are actually kind of weak. It's easy to forget, really. Okay. But he stopped attacking this province right here. Which is actually ours, isn't it? A strange chest of unknown metal was recovered by your man while they looted the holding. Try as they might, they haven't been able to force the chest open and its contents remain a mystery. It has now been deposited in your care. One day that chest will be open, mark my words. Well, why don't we just send you over to down here, to Ostermark, and just plunder that land. And you will no. You know what, just stay where you are and siege that stuff down. We'll take care of this take care of this army first. You will get me as a leader, and we'll just attack them before they can take the Taldom, because I think that's actually going to win them the war. Ah, well, yep, they won. Damn it. Yeah. Ah, oh, my war ended as well, so that's sad. But at least now I can vassalize this guy. I mean, did he lose greenskin lands? Yeah, he did lose two greenskin holds. The sword complete. You hold in your hands a glowing rune blade. It shall become an heirloom of your house, and neither mortal nor demon shall be able to escape its sharp bite. Excellent. A rune sword has been completed for us. Sadly, it's not an heirloom. That's the problem with it. It's not yet an heirloom. But I talked about that like the last two episodes, and you know, I think we now know that it's not an heirloom. I think I've clarified that more than enough. So why don't we go ahead and make maybe a ring for ourselves? What kind of ring would be good for a goblin? Good question. Let's find a mage in our court. Law of the War. We have a bunch of mages. But they all have potential one, which is sad because I would like to have, you know, a stronger one. You are petty. Pretty, not petty. Law of the War. Commission a magic item. We know that an amulet costs like 800, so I should not do that right now. That would be foolish and drive me into, you know, debt again. So let's go ahead and more options. Make a magic ring. A ring of persuasion. I don't really want that, but I can't say no, so yeah, sure. Let's have a ring of persuasion for now. I will probably gift that to someone else, like my son, maybe. Because I want a ring. You know, I guess I can't get a better ring. Because I can't actually get a better mage. I think the greenskins are limited to that law. Like, if you just search all and say law of the war. Wow, what is this? Out of diplomatic range, okay. I'd never seen that before. Oh, this guy actually has magic power too. So, I've lied to you. But I think that's it. No, this guy also has magic power too. And he's... okay. This is Zad. Right here. Okay, so there are goblins with magic power too. So if I could get... yeah, sure. Get this guy into my court. That won't work out badly. Because that's just perfect. Okay, so there are some goblins with magic power too. Maybe we can get some of these into my court. Sadly, there's no easier way to, like, look for magic power too. A lot of orcs with magic power too. There are actually a lot of greenskins that have magic abilities. So Zad, for example, was one. Like, if we just search for Zad. Zad. I mean, how many Zads can there be? What the frick was that? What are you? A breeder? There are no Skaven females, only Skaven breeders. Yo, that's actually quite scary and disgusting looking. Okay, let's go for Zad again. And he should be of my culture. There he is. Why won't you come to my court? Like, you hate your leash. I'll send you a gift. Will you now come to my court? No. Higher tier, what? What do you mean, higher tier? Well, Zad, you know what? I will make you an important character. Because I want you in my court at some point. Because you're a pretty good goblin in range, really. No idea why you are under control of you know, the vampires down here, but so be it. So will we declare a war against these guys? Like, what kingdom could I take from the Robsmen? Translinsk? They don't really have that much in that kingdom. You know, all of these small clans are kind of a waste to war against. These guys up here as well. So are the most of the Empire nations now. You know, we could declare war against Hochland, but we need to... Or Hochland. But we need to have a border with them. Let's attack this green skin for now. Why? Because I can. And we'll just get the Kislevit goblin hordes. Because they're quick and easy to be recruited. And they are very numerous as well. One of my bosses has been smashed. Okay. Sure, why not? Can I actually vassalize this guy? No, because Distant Realm. Sad. I would love this to have Everpeak under my control. It's a very strong holding. Like, it's very good. It has a huge garrison. Even for especially for a goblin hold. Well, it's a goblin hold now. It was a dwarven hold before, of course. So what is, we should have like five or so, four personal combat skill now. That's pretty good. I'm stubborn. And I'm depressed. That, we need to get rid of that. I mean, it's not like we can die from it, but it's still not very nice to have it. Stop this. It's not worth losing so many men. Splendid. Some warriors? Yes. A small horde of 8,000 warriors. I can disband them immediately because I won't need them in this war, and they will just disappear under the war after the war anyway. So Badrak will train with us. Your daily routine involves repeatedly swinging your blade at a training dummy. However, you can only learn so much from fighting an inanimate enemy, and the practice gets dreadfully dull after a while. I could use someone to train with. Not sure if that works like that, but okay. Farak Core Tribe has been looted by me. What? Oh, no, he has looted me. Speaking of looting, we have like a mutual agreement with this rat to loot each other. But I cannot loot him until a year. Like, the rats are really wealthy. It's actually surprising how much money they have and how much they will give to me once I raid them. Okay, send home our force. So who does this province belong to? That's your province right here. The clan of Plois. It's even a greenskin holding. It's orcish, but it's okay. As long as you don't make an orc vessel over here. He also immediately began to make the greenskin the province green, which is nice. How about these provinces? Greenskin Wrecking. Okay, you do have the prestige for it, so that's very nice. Thank you for doing that. These provinces up here all have been made green. That is very good. Probably could attack Eponia. You know, why don't we attack Eponia? Oh, because they have land over here. This dwarf is not something I want to mess with. What about this beastman right here? And what about this guy? It's also just a Chaos Undivided bastard. So let's just invade Ursul and call in all our vessels, and they will deal with it. Don't even have to do stuff myself. Praise Gorg. Zealots. Also not really needed in this war. I would like to have some raiders. Look at all the goblins that are coming to my cause. It's not really that many, to be honest, in comparison to my force. Like, I have 70,000? Yeah, 60,000 at the moment. So we raided something, I think. Maybe not. Sounded like it. We are making money. So how old am I? I am... Well, no, not my age. How long am I ruling? I'm ruling for like... 6 years. So, roughly 8 more years until my Wyvern should be ready, I think. I think I actually ordered the Wyvern rather quickly. Why are we fighting these guys? Are they like raiders? Yeah, they are raiders. You nearly beat them, but, you know, only nearly. Can go home, I don't want you. Gather the boys. I don't know, need that. Wait, what? I'm only a kingdom? When did that happen? I need a second kingdom title, apparently. Well, that's rather easy to get. Like the kingdom of Azuli over here, for example, could be made. Or the kingdom of Kislev. Kingdom of Red Eye Mountain. It's probably the easiest to create, but also very expensive. How expensive are these other kingdoms? Like, you are creatable. The ring is complete. Shaman Gosnik of Svetinyevo has given you your ring of persuasion. Using a subtle combination of charm, magic, and increased sensitivity to the flow of a conversation, it is a powerful tool in all negotiations. Plus five diplomacy. While not a common item, the silver ring is surely to grant a bonus to the wearer's negotiation abilities, making for a great steward. That's not really true, it's a better, you know, shouter, but whatever. For now, we will take it. We now have a ring of persuasion. So let's save up our money for a kingdom title, and then we will save up our money for probably an amulet of protection. Or whatever this other goblin can make us, you know? See, he's not bad. I don't really need a health potion at the moment, because I haven't lost any limbs yet. So, Kingdom of Azuli. Just a bit more money, like literally one more gold coin, I think. Oh, I need piety. How am I going to get that much piety? Easy question. I won't, actually. So why don't we do what we always do when we need a second kingdom title? Just go assassinate another goblin king. This is an orc. Yo, these guys are too aggressive. But the dwarves are just destroying them right now. But still, this guy is way too aggressive. The orcs should show him what it's worth. Not that they really can. I thought the Neherkarans were supposed to stay inside Neherkara, but it certainly doesn't look like it. What are you? You look really cool with your, you know, hat on your head. So these guys are not actually kings. And you are actually an orc now. So the goblins down here were beaten badly. Which makes sense because they're, you know, goblins. Goblin scum. Wait, I'm a goblin scum as well. Whoops. Well, there's no other goblin king that I can easily kill, sadly. We are the strongest goblin horde. I kind of don't want to just invade the Robsmen and take all of their land, because it's going to take forever to convert their land to, you know, to make them green. But other than that, it's like, I don't really want to waste my war on them. Speaking of a war, I should probably use some of my prestige to upgrade Kislev further, because Kislev is really important to us. So, wait, we can upgrade the Greenskin Palisades further? Not that it really matters all that much, but it's not that big of an upgrade anymore. So, I probably want Night Goblin Caves. So let's build those. Yeah, sure. Okay, you will take this province. Why are you getting attrition? No idea. Okay. I looted something. Got a lot of gold. As your men return from the looting, the hold, one of them hands you an axe with a strange purple sheen and a plus etched into the handle, followed by the number 2. After waiting it carefully in your hands, you toss aside your old grey axe in favor of the new weapon. I feel stronger. Oh, nice. Just +2 martial. For nothing. That's always good. Let's leave this province and go over here. Okay, I have to get through here, so, you know, just kill the Osamakar army in your way. Even though I do not like to lose... Oh, they went out of my way. That's nice. I don't like to lose men of this army right here, because they are not reinforcing. So if I could avoid that, that'd be nice. Can we actually loot this? That's a good question, because I think we can. Like, we are bordering them, right? I don't see money being brought to me. I assume we can. Yes. This is split between all looting units. Province does not border the realm of you. Oh, okay, they do not border me, so we need to get in here. Oh well. Let's crush the Ostermarker army. They're actually really weak in comparison, for some reason. Barely lost anyone. But this province can be looted, right? Any gold this unit will loot will be added to its treasury directly. Yes, okay, that's exactly what I wanted. We could probably loot these guys as well, again. So why don't we do that? Now we actually have a lot more to raid them with. Which is also nice, so... Move these 11,000 men down here. And then just raid his land. This war up here should be over. Is it not? Oh, because he owns this isle right here. My vessels are actually incompetent. It's kind of sad. Army of Tog. And the others are just Blindgid armies. Defeat the Ursula tribe. Loot this red province. We probably need some new commanders. So, you are a lucky commander, and maybe my heir. Because, you know, he needs to grow. Oh, he is actually very big already. He's also maimed. So he will surely get a health potion once I can afford that. But right now, I actually like him being maimed, because that means that he's weaker than me. Like, a lot weaker. And he won't try to attack me. That's good. Because he's a big goblin. Maimed is actually giving yourself -4. That's pretty brutal. Okay, could you just assault this hold? Like, there's barely anyone holding it. Boss Scabinus of Shirokree Forest has given me bizarre and repulsive evidence concerning Big Boss Grumbler of Kalinora's sexual preferences. How should I use this juicy information? I will keep it to myself. Why are you losing so much men? Like, do you not have the... Maybe they don't have that, because the high military organization, only I have that, apparently. Oh well. We have a lot of money now. So, thanks to my group... the smuggler's ring in West Rock Mountain has been destroyed. We had a smuggler ring in West Rock Mountain? I didn't even know that. So, Zed, how are you doing? How are you doing? Still don't want to come to my court, huh? Higher tier, I think it means because I'm not an emperor. And that is quite insulting to me, because I should be an emperor. I don't really know how to get the last prestige. The last piety, it's taking a long time. Why did you not conquer this? You are actually in disgrace, you guys. To the goblin race. I will send these 8,000 men up here, because apparently my troops are incompetent up there. Well, not my troops, but my vessels. My troops are actually quite good. Okay, Red Holding has been looted. That's why I got so much money all of a sudden. Victory. Important. Gather the boys. Now, I do not want to gather the boys. Like, that's actually way too weak, to be honest. For 800 prestige, 2,500 men, why would I need that? Like, if they are not all heavy infantry, then that's quite a weak force comparison to my, you know, 50,000 men that I can recruit normally. 70,000. Oh, the war is won, but I think we can just end it now. Because we will get the Jarldom of Ursulu and all occupied titles. So yeah. We don't actually need to occupy the war target. It's even better. No, don't disband my levy. Disband these guys, because these guys over here need to continue raiding the enemies. What kingdom is this? This is one kingdom, one big kingdom, so it goes to you. Yes. That is correct, right? No, apparently my son is ruling over this territory for some reason. You know what? He already has all that stuff, so I will give it to this guy right here, because it's his territory now. The Clan of Urso. Don't really have the prestige to do it, but you will have to, you know, just work with it. And now I don't have to worry about making these provinces green. Also, this province is no longer going to break off because we've built the one building in it that we needed. Victory, more money for us. Let's build a troll pen. Yes, very nice. And just loot everything. What is this? Under Empire. Okay. Gashnid has smashed Big Boss Gnashli. Wait. Okay. One of your bosses in a fight and has taken his place of the clan. Oh well. That happened. While raiding this province, you managed to round a sizable number of slaves. You can either sell them via a separate decision, or else use them in your own demands provinces. Round them up. Well, how can I sell them? Expel the Strigani. I don't have Strigani in my realm. I think. Do I? Do I have a Strigani in my realm? Strigani. No, I don't. I'll actually probably, you know, search for any culture. That probably will work out better. Strigani? No, we do not have a Strigani. I don't know why I can expel them. I don't even want to expel them. 10 gold for this girl, sure. Open the slave menu. I want to sell them. Sell my human slaves for 50 gold, yes, sure. That's good enough. Okay. Let's go ahead and get my... Go to my realm. So, go to Law of the War. I can type. Law of the War. And look for the mightiest goblin in my court that can, you know, do the law. Which is apparently none. And they are all very weak. Like, let's go for my culture and just search all. Maybe some of them. I wish there was an easier way to find, like, magic power, but I think there is not, because it's not a trait, it's like a modifier. Let's first look at these guys that would accept, which are not many. I thought there were more than just Zed, but I don't find anyone that has a high magic power at the moment. Like, what? Something is wrong here. Because these guys do not have the magic power that I need. Oh well, let's just go to one that is in my court, like this guy. I think you're the one that I commissioned last time as well, so that's why you have so much money. I will commission an item from you, and I will say, give me an amulet. An amulet of protection. Very nice, okay. So that's all the magic items we can get from a level 1 mage, which... You know, we can get better items, for sure. Kislev has built its tribe, which is nice. So many troops here now. Like, so many troops. Victory, we raided a lot of land. Looters have completely destroyed the construction of the trade post in Veld. Very good. I still don't understand why I cannot build a better better trade post right here. Like, who has that? No one has that. In range, at least. Like, sorry for that, if you heard that. Like, no one actually has a trade route upgrade. Oh, you have. That could be still in range. Yeah, that could still be in range. Go up here and raid this land now. We want to destroy this province. This green skin. No, wait, what? This trade post, because I want to build it in Kislev. That has a super strong army right now, Kislev. We're still raiding the Rats' land, so that's good. You know, raiding this. What is this? A city? It's a fortress. What is this? It's a temple, and this is a city. So we're currently raiding fortress, but it doesn't really have a good fort level, so that's nice. Oh, they already all have pretty bad fort levels. Could you stop raiding me? Like, what is going on with you? What's wrong with you? Get out of my land. Looters have completely destroyed the castle and Burg in Sieb Gor. Oh, that is actually kind of sad. I did not mean to do that. Sorry. Oh, okay. A big courtier goblin is attacking me. The Randgomgits is challenging you to a fight for the clan. Show him who's the boss. I'm gonna smash your head. I shall defeat him. Okay, so... we're gonna attack him. You've slain your enemy. Oh, well, that was pretty easy. I wanted to use some other options as well, but I wanted to start with an attack. Oh well. That happened then. No, I still do not want this idiot back. You can actually, like, kill him, even as, like, leper. Oh really? Another one attacks me. It's also a big goblin. Gonna bash in your head. Okay, so let's attack him. You've slain your enemy here. I'm actually too strong. I'm too strong at this point. With my rune sword. I'm also a pretty good martial guy. And soon we will have a wyvern, so I shouldn't, you know, speak too quickly. We've got more human slaves. Because if we die now, then we're gonna lose everything. All of our magical items, our wyvern. And could you stop this already? I am the greatest, yes. Who are you the lord of anyway? Okay, could you stop this now? Okay, what have I taken here? Nothing. I just killed someone and got a lot of prestige for it. Stop attacking me. Like, have you seen that? I can't... once an AI guy does a duel, you have like to wait for 2 years or so. And I'm just being attacked by all the goblins at the same time. I don't even know why. Like... They don't have any chance. They haven't even wounded me. They just die. They really should stop. I'm too strong for them. Okay, one last province. We're just gonna quickly take it. And send the troops home. Very nice. Now we just need to wait for this trade post to be destroyed. Oops, sorry. And all is well. We have so much money, it's actually unbelievable. It's actually unbelievable. Wait, what is this? Since when are you... Wait, what is this? How did... Is this like a rebellion? Fanging against Packlord? No. I guess you just... You know, these guys went independent for some reason. I'm not gonna complain. Let's try to take over this province real quick. In a siege, you know. Then take the city. My amulet is complete. Chairman Gosnik of Svetjanovo has completed an amulet of protection +1. It will protect both your person and for short periods of time. Its range can be extended on the battlefield to deflect hostile arrows from your force. So, another personal combat skill. So, we just need a wyvern, and we are actually too strong to deal with. I would like to invite you for a small gathering of friends. I will come for sure. Okay, so, why don't we go ahead and look for, Like, Zad, come on, dude. No, no, don't gift him my stuff. Doesn't want to join me. Can I actually search for magic potential? No. So just lore. I'm gonna do this once more. To quickly look through if some of these guys actually have, like, a better magic potential. To maybe commission a better item. I'm doing something wrong because I don't actually see Zad in here anymore. Like, search for all. My culture. Is that not of my culture? He's a Oh, you know what? That's it. There are goblins around, and I'm a night goblin. So, yes. That's probably why. So let's search for my culture group. We will not take any orcs, obviously, because that's a huge mistake. We'll just look for a magic potential 2 shaman to hopefully invite him into our court. This guy's magic potential 2. Why do you not want to join me? You have no reason to move. You do like your liege too much. If I send you a gift, will that change? You are blind. That will not change your opinion. Sadly. Ah, you are Zad. Yeah, you're Zad. You will not join us because I think you are... Your leash is a rank higher than I am. So that's the problem there. And we can't easily just make her an empire again because... we don't have the prestige for it. The piety. Yeah, a couple of claimants for the King of Kislev. That doesn't really bother me. I have four trade posts. This trade post belongs to me. It apparently belongs to me. That's good to know. I didn't know that. It makes me money, so that's nice. Anything that makes me money is good. It's actually nice being a goblin and swimming in trade money because that makes absolutely no sense. But okay. I mean, we are raiding a lot as well, so that's working out for us as well. Okay, now, you know what? A war against this guy would actually be quite good now, because he has this kingdom up here. Dragorf. We could take this in one swoop and just make it green. So maybe I'm gonna do that. He does have a lot of troops. He does have a lot of troops. But if I just declare a war against him... Not sure if I'm not gonna do it this episode, maybe next episode. I will look for some better war targets, maybe. Like, you know, a war against Bretonnia would be pretty sweet. Like a Coron or something, but we obviously can't reach them right now. We also should start conquering more of these lands. I'm hesitant because I don't want to have so many non-green lands. It's always a little bit of a bummer. You've arrived at the private rooms of Big Boss Grumbler. There's plenty of food and drink here, and the mood is... decidedly merry. We are looking forward to this. Let's get it started. Big Boss Grumbler, the Crowler, has created the title Horde of Shirokshi. That title. These days of revelry are an excellent escape. So many laughs and so many intense conversations. In such short times, it brings you closer to your companions. You feel like good friends already. You're my best friend, my son. My son is not my best friend. That's good. Oh wow, I might lose suppression. The reveling and carousing is over for now, time to get back to real life. Well, it was fun. Sadly, I did not lose suppressed, but it was, the option was there. So we didn't actually commission my item because I'm an idiot. So, you, Boss Zord of Naktar, commission an item. I can't. Okay, I'll just go for my realm. Boss Blotno, can I commission an item from you? I can. Do it. I want a potion. And just give me a potion of healing. Just in case. I could give it to my son. But I don't want to do that just yet. Because I don't want to make him stronger, really. Making him a threat is quite... would be quite idiotic. Okay, so we destroyed the trade post up there. But it was not... not that. Is it really this trade post? Because that's gonna be impossible to destroy. Anyway, we will retreat our force here. And how long? How long have we been ruling? For 10 years now. So our Wyvern is nearly complete. This guy attacks me. Attack the enemy. You've slain your enemy. Okay. I think I'm gonna go for, you know, a year more. Because I think our Wyvern should be... Yeah, there it is. There it is. It has been 10 years and your Wyvern mount stands ready. It is a worthy ally and will give you many advantages in battle. Come here, you big luck. Wyvern mount gives me 2 monthly prestige, 3 personal combat skill, 10% movement, 10% morale damage, 10% morale defense. So, yeah, sure. Fight me, man. Attack my enemy. You've slain your enemy. Like, what kind of combat skill? He had none, probably. And I have 8. I am literally the strongest goblin around. I think I could actually rival, like, an orc in combat. Yeah. I could rival an orc in personal combat. Not this orc, but this orc over here. I probably could not rival Cetra, but that's kind of, you know, that makes sense. He's a cannibal. Oh. Interesting, I did not know that. He also has a rune sword and a lesser amulet of protection. He's also Cetra. He actually has his own trait. I love that. But yeah. Cetra, he's pretty dope. Don't try to mess with him. But most other, you know, mortals, I can pretty much take on in 1v1 combat now. I thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, then consider leaving a like and a comment down below. And we will see us in the next episode. Until then, take care. Bye.